Hello and welcome back to my channel. I'm Arpita Chukkar. Today I'll be talking about this brand called Minimalist. I was very excited to try this brand since quite some time now. A lot of beauty bloggers have been talking about this brand since quite some time, and I did get to try a bunch of their products, and I'm not disappointed. Without any further ado, let's get straight into the video. The product number one is the toner. It's Minimalist toner, that is PHA 3% plus biotic toner. It also has the good ingredients such as niacinamide, which is extremely awesome for the skin, and salicylic acid, which helps in controlling the acne issues, and it also helps in maintaining the pH balance of your skin, which is amazing. Well, my experience of using this toner is pretty good because I didn't expect it like that, because I have a issue of blackheads and whiteheads, and I'm always on a hunt to search for products which could minimize my blackheads near the nose, and for some reason this does help in controlling the blackheads. It has actives, of course, and that is why I prefer not to use it twice a day. I usually use it at night, or especially like I use it on the alternate nights, just because this is what I feel like. But you know, the brand says that you can use it in your AM as well as PM, but don't forget to use your SPF 30. It's like after cleansing your face, you can just apply a few drops of it and apply it like a normal toner that you use. And so yeah, but because it contains a lot of actives in it, I prefer using on the alternate nights. It works fantastically. And if you're looking for something with actives and you are just skeptical about using one, I think this is one great product, because this is the first time I started using actives is with this brand, and I'm not disappointed. I think you should definitely check it out. Moving on to the next product, that is Minimalist AHA PHA exfoliating serum. This is a weekend exfoliating serum. I was highly into this scrubs, physical exfoliators, from a quite long time now, and I enjoy using the physical exfoliators. You will see a lot of my videos, I'll be talking about the scrubs. I somehow enjoy these scrubs, which has got this round scrubbing particles, but somehow I just wanted to try this one from this brand Minimalist. I did see a lot of people using it, and I was so amused with this product. It contains AHA 25% and PHA 5%, BHA 2%. The combination of which helps in the clearing of the dead skin cells, the blackheads, the whiteheads, and it just works like magic. I mean, for someone who hasn't used it before, like chemical exfoliators before, it feels like magic. You just have to cleanse your face, pat dry your face, and then apply a few drops of it, avoid the eye area of course, and just spread it on your face, keep it for 10 minutes and then wash it off. You will see a very visible difference of having that clean, smooth skin, that baby soft like skin, and even the dark head, blackheads will be gone. And that was one of the very weird and strange experiences that I had. This is something that you don't feel when you use a physical exfoliator, and it also you know, results in some micro tears when you use the harsh physical exfoliator. So I think I am slowly switching on to the physical chemical exfoliators, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. But one thing for sure, don't use it more than once a week. I usually use it on the weekends. So that is a thumbs up from my end. Moving on to the product number 3, that is this alpha arbutin 2% plus HA 1%. So what does alpha arbutin do? It helps, like, you know, mildly helps you in controlling the melanin on the top of the surface. It kind of suppresses that melanin to pop out on the top of the surface. So who can use this? Usually people with some mild acne issues, or sorry, the scar, acne scars, or some pigmentation around the mouth, and you know, some scars, people who have these problems can use it. I didn't have any major issues as such. I did have a little bit of scars that was caused by pimples, and I was very excited to try this one out. And it does give some sort of a brightening effect on the skin. I'm a dusky person. My skin tone hasn't changed, but whenever I use this, I do feel some slight, difference between my skin tone. I'm nowhere promoting that fair is lovely or something like that, but I did have a little bit of scarring, and I like that glow which I get after I use this one. I do use this every night. It is very hydrating as well, and I use this after using my vitamin C serum. Like, I cleanse my face, I use a toner, vitamin C, and then alpha arbutin, and then top it up with a good moisturizer. That is at the night time. That's quite a thorough skincare routine that I follow. Okay, and who can avoid this is if you don't have any such pimples, scars, or acne pigmentations or anything around. I do have some sort of pigmentation around my mouth. Yeah, usually people with dusky skin do have the pigmentation around the mouth. The next day of using this serum, it does make me feel like, it just gives that boost of glow on my face, which I really like and enjoy. I did use this one, Minimalist Retinoid 2%. I had this crazy idea. When I turned 28, I just felt like I was getting old. Okay, so in fact, before turning 28, like 3 months before that, I tried the Retinoid 2%. Mostly I couldn't make out any difference as such, because of course I'm too young to comment on how a retinoid is working. But yes, if you're using a retinoid, it's 25 plus is a very nice age to start up with the anti-wrinkle or anti-aging sort of serum. So that is why I tried. I'm not very keen on using it again, because personally speaking, I didn't feel anything, because of course I'm young again. So I don't know, I'm not going back to retinoid anytime soon, or I might. I'm 28, I might need it soon. Yeah, I've tried the moisturizer from this brand. I don't have it right now. The oats moisturizer, but I am not very keen of it. I didn't like it, because it's just a pretty okay sort of moisturizer. It doesn't have any fragrance and all of that. All these products don't have any fragrance. It does have a base ingredient as aloe vera, which is slightly concerning to the people who might be allergic to aloe vera. So even this retinoid has got aloe vera in it. Yes, it does have aloe vera, and people allergic to aloe vera should stay out of this brand as such. And all the ingredients are mentioned, and it's a very clean brand with no silicone, no parabens, no dyes, no fragrance and all that. It's a very clean brand, and it's very safe to use. My experience of using all these products has been amazing. Something that I don't really like in this, I'm not a fan of, is that oats moisturizer. But other than that, I really love it, and I enjoy. I'm yet to finish all this, okay. And I like, and that little bit of product goes a very long way. I'm thoroughly enjoying it. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like the video, please hit like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Also, I would really love it if you could comment below and help me grow. And see you until next time. Bye.